Lorena, what is the next game, please?
The next game is Barcelona men against Australia. They are playing here to get from 9th to the 12th place.
Australia against Barcelona?
Yes, okay. The men team.
So we have a question from Lena Lee. So after discussing the different fins, which one would you recommend to buy? This is not an easy question and not easy to answer. It depends on your level of expertise. To how long do you play underwater rugby? Are you a beginner? I would recommend softer fins and more easily to handle fins. If you play for a longer time, it's a decision which position you play. If you look for a fast and not easy to learn to fin, it would be waterways fiberglass. And if you're looking for an agile and teaching fin that teach you how to swim, I would recommend the Nayare, which are really durable and made of full rubber. But they're really short, so if you're a defender, I prefer them.
For mobility, yes.
Yeah, mobility. So level is 1 year of playing. Which one did you have before? Which fins are you used to, Lena? And while we get the answer to this question, Jörg, there is one thing that interests me. what we can from martial arts, learn from martial arts. We had one player, he knew all the holding, get rid of holdings, in which way to move, how to open up holdings, tackles. And that was really interesting. He taught us how you get out of every grip, how you get out of a hold of your ankles, of your knee. And I think there are some things we could learn from these, not punching, not full contact martial arts, but more like a movement martial art.
In this sense, if you play the ball fast, you will be not hold. So forget about this. For me, it's more the repeating a certain moving pattern. And that is what the martial art is intensively doing.
Okay, that's
that
again muscle memory.
Muscle memory, muscle memory, muscle memory. The movement. You should be aware, if I move in this direction, I will be get someone on my arm. If I move in different direction or something like that. For me, one of the tricks in a cluster, don't use power. Just put the hand.
True. Yeah.
Just put the hand on the ball. The others are shaking and doing this and something.
And
put a lot of energy, and you don't do nothing.
Yeah.
So basically, and then wait.
The minute, exactly.
Okay, here we are in the game and
quick start.
Yeah, there was a quick start, and I think for Wales, it's really important now to win this game here in their first appearance in the Champions Cup, and they had a really great performance until now, and they're playing in white against Rugby Super Aquatic from Barcelona in blue, and well, both teams, I think Barcelona probably has more experience, but Australia showed a very good start here in the Champions Cup. They did quite well, so they're good for a surprise, I can think.
I think it's always important to play against strong teams in order to experience a different way of attacking, how physical, something like that, and to adjust the game. And when I see now Australia, where they have not so many chances to play against, in brackets, in strong European teams, I have to say that they're making very good moves, and they're now very aggressive. On they're getting also more physical on the goal than before. Of course, Barcelona gives them maybe some more room than the other teams before, but it's always the question of how to utilize the room.
Yep.
No, that is the and they are there. They try to control the ball. They are fast to go down and to get the ball when it's falling down.
Yeah.
This is the important thing.
Yeah, they have a good presence on the water. This is the second game of the day for Australia, and I have to say that they were mentioning that the jet lag is killing them, you know.
Yes,
they're on the other side of
you.
The war.
Yes,
I mean,
totally.
So now, now
sorry.
Yeah, that is basically now it's sleeping time for them. So
yeah.
And they arrived only 2-3 days ago, so they are totally in jet lag, and we don't see them sleeping on the basket. But I think they're really, we see it with Ricardo with us. He's really like in another time dimension. Call from a referee, free throw against. Australia, they're doing a good job here on putting pressure on the Spanish basket. Sorry again. But the thing is, they have to score to force a decision. Answer again for Lena. I think Stratos are quite good Finns. I used them for a long time. So I think you made a good decision. If you play for a year, you can use the Stratos and maybe then switch to shorter fins, which force you more to swim more with more technique. So back in the game, we have Barcelona putting pressure on the basket of Australia, but they break free, go for a counterattack. Three of them, Australians going for the basket. There is one defender. Down, goalie down, with this movement of the mobile camera, it's really action. You can't even, the whole teams could stand still if you move the camera like that. There's so much action in the,
We have 286 people watching. Do we have any Australians watching the game? What time is it in Australia, by the way, right now?
I have no clue.
Australia.
12 hours? Less
we have, Jörg is traveling a lot, so he will have the perfect watch overview. So Australia is still in attack mode, but Barcelona recover the ball and try to break free, but it's heavily forechecked on the surface, and there was a call from the referee. I think the ball was out of the pool area. We have 286 people in the live chat. Anybody from Australia watching this game right now?
At 5:36 in the morning.
In the morning. Wow.
So Australia should wake up now.
So they are in the middle trying to get a grab of the ball, and Barcelona achieves that, but Australia, you know, don't let a little space so that the counter attack can go through. And they are now coming down towards the Australian basket. And they just lost the ball, and Australia is trying to
call from a referee.
Go away, yeah. And apparently, well, I don't know, free throw for Australia.
I'm really impressed by Australia.
Yeah, they've been playing great matches. Now we have attack from Australia towards the Spanish basket, and they are a bit static for my taste. They just move a little bit more, but let's see, maybe they have to find themselves. I don't know, they were playing a bit better than the games before. Right now they seem a little bit more quiet somehow than before, or they had more reaction time. And we have one, the Australians just got the ball, it's right by the goalie, but two of the defenders pull him away, and they're in the surface. Two Australians are underneath trying to wait for the ball to fall. The Spaniards are pushing the one with the ball toward the middle field, so they are away from the basket. I mean, in the last few games, I've been seeing a lot of clusters game and on the surface. And I don't know if because they were tired, or they were too nervous, or because in the games before, we had, you know, more swimming.
More
or maybe
we're yes.
Seeing the more inexperienced teams. So that's, you know, something they normally tend to do. The most experienced teams normally
don't.
Call
from a referee again. Three minutes left.
But I personally like the approach of the Australian team. So they
yes.
They put a lot of effort in this game, and they have good bottom time. They try to.
Their coach is Carlos. Yeah, they trained with us on Wednesday, and Ricardo is staying with us. He brought a lot of knowledge over there, and Bobby is also a very important figure, as Ricardo told us, in the development of Australian underwater rugby.
And as we can see here again, it's a matter of personal engagement, and it's a good approach on the goal from Australia. Keeping too long the ball on the goal side.
He should have tried go out when the first attempt didn't work out.
Yeah, but you see the goal, you feel
absolutely.
It can happen and something like that.
Yes.
And if you consider this, it will never happen.
Yeah.
But that's a personal engagement, and that is the coaching activities, the people who encourage the players to train hard, to try something out. And it comes, everything comes down to the how the coach or the come into the player's head.
Yeah.
You can tell everything if the people don't agree, and then you have no
means to know to translate your knowledge into the game of the players.
Yeah.
So
the good thing is that to let people experience that things are working out.
Yes, that's the best way to show them. So let's go, please. Look, let's go back in the game, because otherwise the people watching they're just let's play, talk about these themes in the breaks. So we have. Barcelona in defense again, and Australia is in ball possession coming from the close side. Now one player, there's a call from the referee, surface, free throw against Barcelona. Didn't see what happened. So again, an attack from above. They're here passing down to the player in the right in front of the basket, but they don't succeed. Tackled away, and he goes up to the surface, playing to his colleague, and he goes up to the surface, taking a breath. They play quite fast, but this was a risky pass. And was lost to Barcelona because the player couldn't recover it right in front of the basket. Always dangerous to pass this close to the basket, but the defender can just go forward. So, break here in the first half of Barcelona against Australia. And very good game by Barcelona, no doubt. Our eyes are right now on Wales. Because this is the first appearance on the Champions Cup, and they do quite good in playing in a very open, fast style of underwater rugby. Like it very much. Lorena is back with us. So, no martial arts, water doesn't play any role in underwater rugby, the water quality, because both teams are in the same water. So, another question, the pool. Different pool, different sizes, the rules now allow big pools for championships, so we have a broader possibility to play tournaments worldwide. That's something that's looking for the global community to offer tournaments. What do you prefer as a game tournament?
As a coach, I prefer bigger pools.
Because
you have more space, and more space means less body contact, less thrusters and something like that. So it makes the game faster. And when I remember the World Championship was played in a 450 pool that was very good for the teams. And smaller pools has, I think, the risk of more clusters and less dynamic. So, and it's for me, it's amazing. No? 50 centimeters on each side more makes a totally different.
It makes a difference, yeah. That's
when
true.
You look for the roots, now we're talking about somehow roughly 400 cubic meter to 1,000 cubic
yeah.
meter.
Yeah, that's,
so
that's
a big,
big,
big allowance. Yeah. So with the new rules, even more.
Yeah.
About that, but something like the length, I think, is something 18 meters, 20 meters are fine. The depth should be 4 to 5 meters to have an attractive game.
Yeah.
Of course, as a player, you prefer maybe a smaller pool because you don't have to go down so deep
yeah.
and
yeah.
something like that. But the music plays always on the bottom of the pool.
So
that's the reason why the gold, we put the gold there.
Ah, that's
huh?
why.
Yeah,
no, I understand.
Yeah, that's,
so let's go back in the game here. Second half, Barcelona against Australia. Australia in white and Spain in blue, and it's still 0-0. And Australia gives the probably more experienced Barcelona a good fight here. I'm impressed. And they're doing super good with the jet lag and everything and the not experience of international games. So what we see here in this very moved picture is a fight here in front of the Australian basket on the surface. We have a cluster, a lot of bubbles. We don't see it clearly. But Australia is in defense. Ricardo is lying in front of the basket. And Barcelona is trying to attack from the close side. But the forechecking of Australia is keeping them away. And there was and wasn't any contact yet with the defense. On the goal or in front of the goal. Now they go in. Now Barcelona really tries with one player to go in with force, but they are tackled away. And there is one Australian player tackled by two Spanish players right above the basket at the wall. We see a lot of Finns standing on the step. Shouldn't be possible. And here,
oh,
is,
pass.
Here is a counterattack from this very agile big Australian players.
There are two.
Oh.
And they just, oh, that was such a pity. They were almost
this
in other way.
This was an excellent attack. Two players on one side, a strong attack.
But they almost fought against each other. I think one of them didn't realize it was his colleague down there. And they tried to get the ball free from him. But they attacked from the open side and looked quite forceful and could have been quite a goal.
I think the attacks from two players on one side is very effective. Most of the time not taken so often. But yeah, that is also somehow experience. That is something you can train, how to attack the goal and go from one side or change to the middle side. And this is actually, I guess, not so often trained. So you see some players in your experience, and you know what you move, and more the people watching them than help him. So, and double pass is very seldom.
True.
Yeah, that's very seldom in our sports, especially in counterattacks.
But it should be. It really you see it a lot from the Orcas, for example.
I think there's a lot opportunities to
develop.
To develop and watch to other sports, what they're the tactics they're doing, and it's regardless of soccer, it's American football, it's basketball, or something like that.
Okay, guys, try to focus. Let's stay in the game.
You focus, and I give comments.
All right, slow. I focus and switch off your microphone so you can comment. So
you're
still
so
Australia is
so
on attack.
Gentle.
The Australia is still in attack, and this is quite some time. They're fighting, but they don't succeed in putting a real pressure on the basket. They're a little bit too easy peasy playing here. with the ball around the forecheck and go now from the open side to the basket. Don't succeed, and that was well done. He went, the player went out of the skirmish, and now we have one player coming from the top, trying to push away the goalkeeper, but the goalkeeper himself recover the ball, and there's a call from the referee.
Free throw
against
Barcelona. But right now they are building up a good pressure against Barcelona.
True.
I mean, they're not really very effective the way how they're attacking, but because they are doing it constantly, they are putting the Barcelona team really under pressure. So we have how much time left? From the second time?
It's about 8 minutes, 6 minutes probably. Not that much anymore. I don't think Australia.
Still 0-0. So if no team achieves a score, we have to go to penalties again. Actually, I like to see more penalties. So,
but I think Australia will be not fond of penalties. I don't know how much they train them. Depends.
They have, you know, Ricardo and two other Norwegian experienced
players. You think they can?
I believe that if they go to penalties, Australia still has a good chance.
They are huge players. You look at them; they are quite massive. So that's always a good. Good base for penalties. If you can either be fast, little, and agile, or you can have the massive build, which with long arms, which give you which will give you an edge. So
Castores games will be playing at 9:30, so in 1.5 hours about. So now we have, let's see, another call, free throw against Barcelona. And
the clock is not
showing
on again. we don't see the time clock and the score right now. But still Australia is attacking. Now there's a good chance on the open side. One of the players tries to build a tunnel, but it was a misunderstanding, and his colleague just played the ball to him, but it was meant as a block to protect the attacker. So this is one of the Australian girls going in there, and this is the
they put high pressure now on the goal.
Yes, and it should be. It
but
should be.
I think that they play two risky passes in this.
But still, they keep the ball. They do risky. That's true, but it seems possible to keep the ball like this.
The second and third pass is too risky, so they should take more time. Keep the pressure high, otherwise they give away the ball, and that takes a lot of energy, and it's only 4 minutes to recover the ball. So everyone is beside me eating, so no, thank you.
We have some tomatoes here. Yes. Free throw against Australia again. Let's stay focused. Focused, York. Focus on the game. Focus with everything you have. I know it's hard, but you can do it. Okay, there's an attack from Barcelona on the Australian basket. And the forechecking of Australia is very good. I haven't seen any real danger for the Australian basket. There's a call from the referee again, probably holding without ball.
Attack to the mask.
Okay.
That's 3 minutes left, and
in this second half. So if it's 0-0, we will see penalties, and that will be interesting because until now we've seen a good game from Australia, but we haven't seen them doing penalties yet. So let's stay focused.
Yes.
Don't tell me. Talk to yourself first, and then.
Wolf, stay focused. Okay, yeah. Wolf, I do that. Look, I can talk to me.
You listen to yourself?
I do, all the time. But most of the time I'm quiet, inside myself.
So, free throw for Barcelona. If you can't, I will say focus.
Another call from the referee.
I believe they didn't give the sign to start the free throw. That's where they stopped it. And the time is ticking away.
Yes, that is the problem. The time is ticking away and cost...
both teams on their sides.
So
the referees have a discussion here. We don't know what the issue is right now. The referees are discussing on the surface. Both teams are on their sides. Ricardo is doing a prep talk for the Australians, and Barcelona is already getting ready on their side. They're not discussing much. Can someone please reboot me without breaking my nose?
Why you make somehow the limitation?
Well, my nose was already broken, so it shouldn't be a second time.
So, what do we have here? I mean, out of the pool? What? Timeout?
I think they took a timeout now, yeah. Okay. So, I will get myself a coffee.
So, let's see. They have 2 minutes and 43 seconds. And even though Australia was dominated a little bit more the second half, still both teams, when they get the ball, they reach the other basket and they cannot really... achieve the score in the attack, but they're not really efficient. So I don't see this happening in the next 2 minutes and 40 seconds. So I believe we're going to see some penalties.
And that would be a lucky punch situation.
Yeah.
If the both team are keeping concentrated, I think it will go to penalty throw at the moment. So that it's... a risky game, or you're very confident on your goalkeeper?
Yeah. Well, but for Australia, given the fact that it's the first time here for them, already to achieve a zero, that they have nothing to lose, actually. So maybe because, you know, they don't have that much pressure.
I think this is a very interesting game. Has the energy inside. But there was threatening goal attacks, and but it's good. They still have the dynamic there, and now there was 2-3 on the goal, and then
they have
big
there has
chance,
to be
2 minutes to go.
Go for Australia. No. Yes. No. Okay. Sorry. I dream about it. Yes, it was a pity. It was 3 white against 1 blue, and I really almost saw it inside. I mean, that was a great achievement from the
goalie. Yeah, when you have the this chance maybe 1-2 times a game maximum, and then you should score out of this.
Yep.
So if you know take the energy out of the game, it's not helping. If you're standing still with the ball, everybody else standing still and wait. So that's a typical situation doing underwater rugby. If someone take out the speed, everybody take out the speed. The opponent, but also your team. It's difficult to switch on speed again. So 1 minute to go, so Australian attack. So it's most important not to lose the ball and give Barcelona the chance to have the hand on the ball. So they wait too long at the moment, so I guess, because this is wasting time. Going forward, backward, it's more important. And
so probably the last chance here for Australia, and that's it. Counter-attack for Barcelona, stopped by 2 Australian players. 26 seconds left. We will see a penalty shootout. Quite sure nothing will happen right here anymore. 15 seconds. This is going to be interesting. I don't think at this point of the tournament, no team is looking forward to do penalties. It's late in the evening. We have 8 o'clock here in Berlin. And probably they're quite tired. and penalties are always mentally exhausting for both, as we talked before, for the goalkeeper and the attacker. So if
but
you just
when you win a game by penalty throw, that's the most exciting
that's
thing.
It. Yeah, that's, yeah. That's a high. That's really is a high, definitely.
I think beside the sudden death goal, it's
yeah, it's the best.
It's really an actual experience two times as a goalkeeper in my career to win a penalty shootout, and I was always holding as a goalkeeper the first one, so I never had to go the third one. So that was. For me, an exciting.
It's so, yeah, it's so
and
great.
That is never got out of my mind.
No.
Believe
no.
you. So if you
penalty,
just
yeah.
if you just tuned in, this is Champions
Do you want
Cup
to be
2000.
Focused again?
Yes, I want to tell the people who just switched in. We have how many people in the chat?
286.
200. No, I don't see it. We should do a reload.
Yeah.
But there's a penalty shooting now. You're watching Champions Cup 2016 here in Berlin.
Barcelona against Australia, 0-0 after two times of 10 minutes, and now it's penalties.
And your commentators here are Lorena, world champion last year in Cali as a goalkeeper with German girls, and write to me her coach, Jörg Oertel, the national women's team coach from Germany. And I'm Wolf from Berliner Sporttaucher, and we're doing the penalties right now, but we're watching them, commenting them for you. So this is Ricardo on the basket, and a player from Spain is attacking. He's going from the bottom of the pool and tries to go under. There's
okay.
a call. I don't know.
But
I don't see what happened. No, Ricardo wasn't kicking. I'm quite sure he had his feet quite still. So it was a foul play of the attacker.
No.
Ah, he was going for the throat. Didn't see that one.
2 minutes for Ricardo. Okay.
This I cannot understand.
I don't see the mistake.
Neither do I.
Yeah, sometimes the referees in every sport is a miracle.
They are mathematicians. So repetition here, another goalkeeper from Australia, and the Spanish attacker is coming from above, and he managed to turn around, and while holding the goalkeeper lost his mask and the fin, and is... quite angry about it. No, both teams. The defender, the goalkeeper, was not very happy. He lost his mask and his cap. So now it's it's up to the Australians
you
to
attack. You saw the
attack.
Movement of the attacker. He was doing it clockwise. He was moving in the other direction, and not against clockwise.
Yeah.
And that gives him
an edge.
The open arm.
Interesting. Really, really, I thought about it. So we have the penalty against. The Australian player is coming in really fast into the feet of the.
He should now use the arms and. The ground.
He's
the
under
ground.
The basket now,
the
behind
behind
the back, and he's not turning right as you said before. He's just he's going up again, and
there's a lot of
the
of
goalkeeper is not allowed to go up like this. This is foul play. As a goalkeeper, you're
Two
not
minutes.
Allowed to attack the attacker. In a distance longer than your own body, so 2 minutes for him. We see Karina out there. It looks like the goalkeeper didn't know the rules, and there was a little bit of emotion there. So repetition. Is it the same attacker? I don't know. We have our overwater camera, and this is quite. Whoa! I'm feeling seasick.
Right.
So again, a repetition of this penalty, and this one, this Australian player is taking it slow. He's waiting right on top of...
But this was actually from the goalkeeper was a smart decision. Take a 2 minutes
yeah, that's
penalty,
better than
that's
true.
Get the goal. So, yeah.
So this this attacker is taking his time. He's he's hungering the out for air, the goalkeeper, and he's pushing from the side. Wow, this was
good job.
He pushed him over the basket, and when the gap was there, he with all his force he pushed in the ball. Nice done. A little bit not enough movement from the goalie from the Spanish goalie in this part, but easy to say from our perspective, because if you turn around, you open another gap. Right, it's 1-1.
I'm nervous.
Are you nervous? Doesn't show.
Yeah, really. Well, now Ricardo is back in, so that means he's rested, and now maybe he can make the day. I mean.
Yeah, now it's everything open, but Barcelona is an advantage. So this is for sure always a better position. For the game, so I would prefer that my team always starts with throwing first.
True.
No?
Here we go. Australia's defending and Spain is attacking, and he does the right thing. He's lying right in front of the basket, but
he grabbed the head.
Yeah. But this is all this what we see happening there. The foul play is I think it's accidentally, and it was not on purpose. It was the same goalkeeper we
at
had.
At least the mask is fully gone.
Yes.
Yeah. So
it was visible.
This,
no discussion
this,
about
this,
that.
This accidentally
no
fully
yeah.
gone mask. Yeah. Okay. Stay focused.
I am.
Yeah, but then
focused,
I mean, what
focused,
I don't
focused,
understand
focused.
Is when the attacker does a foul. Well, that's it. I mean,
yeah, that's it.
It's like a
halt.
Yes.
Yeah, but it's still 0-0.
So
no,
it's 2-1.
No, 1-1. Sorry.
So this is now the decisive throw, and this is the very fast and agile player we've seen in the game. He's quite capable, and let's see. It's
sell the skin of the bear first after you shoot the bear. Don't
Jörg, stay focused.
I stay focused.
Focus. Don't dream about beers. Okay, let's go back in the game. This is this he seems quite capable, and he goes down very fast. He's already under the basket, and that was interesting. The goalkeeper moved, so he couldn't be grabbed, pushed away, and
yes, take his time.
Yeah, but he should just probably would be nice to stay down, like they
fine.
Did. Yes, 20 seconds left. Yes.
Wow.
It was exactly right to do this. The defender was under big pressure, and after he get up to breathe, and had 20 seconds. That was
well. Congratulations
was
to Australia and
great second win, one game of the championship for them. So. Great job. I mean, for the first time coming over here and, you know, doing such a good job. I mean, they are playing the 9th to the 12th play, and since they won, they're, you know, going up. So that's really a nice achievement for them, right? I mean,
absolutely. There's no doubt
they're
about
14
that.
Teams, and they won't be the last ones. So now the next game, it's Firenze, it's the girls back. Firenze against Black Mermaids.
The how many teams did Firenze have then today? It's a fourth of them for them or the third?
Firenze had so far one game. This is the second one. This is the second one for Firenze, and
okay, I thought
they are playing
more
for the position 7 to the 9th place against the Black Mermaid.
Okay, 7 to 9.
They have also a triangular, like the same from the first to the third place.
7 to 9 from 10. So we have 207 people watching in the live stream. And always look in the camera. So we're running out of things we can talk about, Jörg. How could this happen? Are we? Do we agree
really
on everything? Do we agree on everything right now?
We
no,
have
I don't think so. But
3.5 hours to go.
You stopped to argue something funny.
Did I?
Yes.
How could this happen?
I have no idea.
Imagine we know each other for quite a long time, but I didn't think it happened so fast. As a really,
yeah, when you run out of energy and run out of questions, can you tell you stories about history of underwater rugby?
I have something we'll talk about. Wait a second. I give you what about
focus. We still have 3.5 hours to go.
Yeah, but
and
we have
watching.
We have no
and
game.
And the best games are coming up. I'm not the best. The most
exciting games.
Exciting games. Yes.
I think that one of the key game will be